infrared sensor comes in a pair. There's one transmitter and one receiver. The transmitter is the white colored one, while the receiver is the black colored one. So what happens is the transmitter will give out infrared light continuously depending on the pulse given. Then if it hits any obstacle and object, it will reflect the light back to the receiver. The receiver will receive the signal from the light, and then we can judge the distance of the object from the sensor. The sensitivity of this sensor can be determined by adjusting its threshold. How do we adjust the threshold? We use a potentiometer and a comparator. By using a comparator, it will give out digital output. I have already explained in the tutorial, so for more detailed explanation, you may refer to the tutorial link, which will be linked down in the description box. So we will do some basic demonstration to apply the usage of this sensor. We will be needing male-to-male jumper wires, the infrared sensor, a buzzer, a NPN2222 transistor, this is a connector, some resistors, a breadboard, and the City Uno. First, I connect this infrared sensor to my breadboard. If you notice that there are three pins below the sensor, I use a connector to connect this sensor to the breadboard. You can also use male-to-male jumper wires, but I find this easier. Then you just plug it in into the breadboard. The first pin is the ground pin, so I connect it into the negative terminal of the breadboard, which will be the ground. The second pin is the receiver pin. And finally, the third pin is the transmitter pin. So I will need to provide voltage for the transmitter and the receiver. So I will be using a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor to connect the receiver to the power source, the 5 volt power supply. For the transmitter, I will be using 100 ohm resistor to connect from the sensor to the 5 volt power supply. So after I did all the connection on the breadboard, it's time to connect all these to the City Uno. You can also use Arduino Uno, but this is the Citron version of Arduino. So I connect the positive terminal on the breadboard to the 5 volts power supply on the City Uno, and the ground is connected to the negative terminal on the breadboard. With this, the connection is complete. Now, to observe the analog value of the sensor, I connect the receiver pin to A0 on the analog pin. And then I use my USB wire to wire it up into my laptop.